गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वी आर स्टडिंग आइडियल गैसेस एंड प्रोसेस विथ आइडियल गैसेस. आई थिंक वी रिक्वायर्स वन और टू लेक्चर्स, दैट इज ऑन दिस चैप्टर्स. दैट्स व्हाई आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग. Problems related with the ideal gases and process of with ideal gases. Please note down today's first problems, which are important. That's why I am taking a gas initially at initially at 14.4 bar and degrees centigrade is expanded isothermically. Isothermically means this is PV equal to constant, means P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Temperature remains constant to a pressures of 2.24 bar. It is then cooled at constant volume till the pressure falls to 1.02 bar. Finally, this is adiabatic compression brings the gas back to its the initial state. The mass of the gas is 0.23 kg and Cp equal to, and this is C 1 kJ/kg. Draw the PV diagrams. Draw the PV diagram and determine the value of adiabatic value of the adiabatic index of compression of compression second bit the change in internal energy of the adiabatic adiabatic process. So changing in the internal energy means that is nothing but the MCV into delta T. Here a gas is initially at 14.4 bars. And this pressure is higher. Suppose this is first point and 360 degree centigrade is expanded to isothermally to a pressure of isothermally. Suppose this is second point, this pressure P1. This is P2 and then it is cooled at constant volume. Constant volume means this is suppose third point. This pressure falls P3 equal to 1.0 to P2 equal to 2.24 and this P1 equal to 14.4 bar. And this is V2 equal to V3 and this is V1. Alright. Compression brings the gas. This is brings the gas back to the initial. Back to the initial conditions. This is compression and this is compression PV rest to gamma equal to constant and this is PV equal to constant and this is volume constant. So first we will see P1 equal to what is given data 14.4 bar. T1 equal to 360 plus 273 and this is 3 Kelvin. Mass is given, mass equal to 0.23. Cp equal to 1 kilojoule per kg. So first we'll calculate V1 is unknown, so that's why by using P1's V1 equal to MRT1 and this is a gas 14.4 bars means R equal to this is correct. So P1 is equal to 14.4 into 10 to the power 5 multiplied by V1, 0.33, and this is 633 V1 equal to. Multiplied by 287, 633 divided by 14.4 divided by 10 to the power 5, 0.029 meter cube, and this is kg. Meter cube, V1 equal to. Right? Now PV equal to constant. So that's why P1, V1 equal to P2, V2, P1 equal to 14.4. This is 0.0290. P2 equal to 2.24. That's why V2 equal to, V2 increase, multiplied by 14.4 and divided by 2.24. This is equal to 0.1865 meter cube. And this is V2 equal to V3, that's why V2 equal to V3. The value of the adiabatic index. So for adiabatic index, first bit, index of compression. That's why, can we write P3, V3 raised to gamma, and P1, V1 raised to gamma. Because P3, this is adiabatic equation. So that's why we can write P3 divided by P1 equal to V1 divided by V3 raised to gamma. P3 equal to this is equal to P3 equal to 1.02 divided by P1 14.4 is equal to log of E, V1 equal to 0.290 divided by V3, 0.1865. I am getting this is negative, that's why I will change this relations. Instead of these relations, I take because this is small, V3 gamma, V1 gamma equal to P1 divided by P3, or V3 divided by V1 gamma equal to P1 divided by P3. Log of E 0.1865 divided by 0290, this is 14.4 divided by 1.02. 4 divided by 1.02, this is 14.1176, and this is 6.4310 log of E. This is equal to 1.806 into 1.806. This is also we requires log. This is equal to 2.6474, and this is gamma equal to, that's why divided by 1.86, because gamma's value is around 1.4233. This is your first answers. Now the change in internal energy job of the adiabatic process. For second answers, change in internal energy. So that's why internal energy equal to, what is formula? MCV into delta T. M, now we request value of the CV. CP given, CP, because CP minus CV equal to R, and this is 0.287. So that's why CP divided by CV gamma, sorry, this is CV. Now CV equal to, this is 1.4233 minus 1 equal to, CV equal to, and this is CV equal to change in internal energy equal to M into CV into delta T. So delta T equal to T1 minus T3. That's why this is multiplied by 0.6779, and this is T1 minus T3. T3 equal to, so you calculated T3 values. So we request now T3 equal to. So T3 equal to, how we can calculate, because this is constant volumes. So that's why P2 divided by P3 equal to T2 divided by T3. I will check this formula. Right. So this T2 is nothing but, and this is isothermally, means T1 divided by T3. So that's why T3 equal to T1 multiplied by P3 divided by P2. T1 633, P3 1.02, P2 equal to 2.24, T3 equal to. Multiplied by 633, and this is T3 equal to 288.24 Kelvin. Now change in internal energy equal to delta U equal to M23 0.6779, and this is T1 This is equal to 53.75 kilojoule. This is internal energy equal to, change in internal energy equal to 53.75 kilojoule. This is clear? Now next problems, this problem is different as compared to previous all problems. One kg of air at one bar and 300 Kelvin is compressed adiabatically means PV raised to gamma till its pressure becomes
its pressure becomes 5 times the original pressure.
Then it is expanded.
Then it is expanded.
At constant pressure.
At constant pressure. And finally cooled. And finally cooled at constant volume to
return
to return to its original conditions.
Calculate
heat transfer and VBIT internal energy.
For each process for the cycle, represent the process on PV and TS diagrams.
On PV and TS means temperature versus entropy diagram.
Take
CV equal to 0.718 kilojoule per kg Kelvin and gamma equal to 1.4. This is air. That's why for air, R equal to, we know, 287. This is standard. So first, we'll draw this diagram on PV and TS diagram. 1 bar at 300 Kelvin is compressed adiabatically. Is compressed adiabatically. Suppose this is first point. Adiabatically. 1:2 till it pressure becomes 5 times. So this is P2 equal to 5 P1 and this is P1. Then it is expanded at constant pressure. And finally cool to constant volumes. So this expanded up to here it is required up to constant volumes, means it's a original conditions. And this is third point. This is pressures equal to constant, and this is volume equal to constant. Now, for TV on TS diagram, temperatures versus entropy. Pressure increase, this is adiabatically, means entropy remains constant. There is, because why this is entropy remains constant, because there is no any exchange above the heat, so that's why entropy remains constant. Next, constant pressure versus, that's why temperature increase and volume constant, pressure. So I think this point, right, this curves, this is correct. So we will go step by step. P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, P2 equal to, that's why 5 bar. So what may be? Yes, we will calculate, because this is adiabatic. So that's why can we calculate by using P1, V1, M, R, T1. M is given, so that's why we can calculate, because this is V1. P1 equal to 1 bar into 10 to the power 5 multiplied by V1. 1, this is 287 and this is 300. V1 equal to, sorry, so as per you knows formulas, try to calculate that values, meter cube. And here's Cv given, as you know, Cp minus Cv equal to R, or otherwise by using formula, Cp divided by Cv equal to gamma. That's why Cp equal to 1.40.718. Cp equal to, (0.9996) kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Now what is to be calculate? Heat transfer and internal energy. So I think this is heat transfer and internal energy, means that is during the cycle. I will check. No, right, during the cycles. So first take process adiabatic. Adiabatic. So for adiabatic process, there is no any exchange above the heat, so that's why Q equal to Q1 is to this is 0. Now internal energy equal to 4:1:2 mCv into delta T. M equal to 1, Cv equal to 0.714, and this delta T, T2 is not known because now we require T2 value. Adiabatic process. So for adiabatic process, what is the relations? Pressures is given. T2 divided by T1s, P2 divided by P1s raised to gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. T2 divided by T1s, and this is 0.4 divided by 1.4. T2 equal to how much? Because this temperature increased 0.4, 2.857. This is equal to 2.857. Five raised to 0.2857 multiplied by T1 equal to 300. 300s. This is equal to 475.13 Kelvin T2 temperatures. So that's why you can calculate delta U 1:2 equal to 1 × 0.714, and this is T2 minus T1. T2 equal to 475, T1 300. This is equal to 125.046 kilojoule. Right? And this is first bit over. Second bit, constant pressure process is 2 to 3. So for T2 means yes, T3 divided by T2 equal to V3 divided by V2, and V3 equal to V1 is divided by V2. T3 equal to V1 divided by V2. V2 is unknown. Constant pressure process. T3 is unknown. So here's because for calculations of the V2, we have to use equations P1 V1 raised to gamma, P2 V2 raised to gamma, because we request V2 here's P1. This is P1 V1 equal to, we already calculated, this is 0.861 raised to 1.4. P2, 5 times P1, V2 raised to gamma. This will get cancelled, and this is 0.861 raised to 1.4 divided by 5. This is equal to V2 raised to gamma. Now, log of E 0.162 gamma log of E. This is V2. You can write this is this is minus this 1.4 this is 2 equal to 0.2725 meter cube. Now we can calculate by using this formula. T3 V1 is equal to 0.861, V2 this is 0.2725, T1 I think 300 Kelvin, 300. So that's why T3 equal to 2. This is not T1, this is T2. That's why 0.861 272 25 multiplied by 475. This is 1501. Kelvin, T3 equal to. So what is to be calculate? Heat transfers equal to. So heat transfers equal to delta Q equal to MCP into T3 minus T2 M1 CP 0.99 6 1501 minus 475.13 minus 475.13 into 9996. This is equal to 10 25.69 unit CP kilojoule. So that's why this is kilojoule. Now change in internal energy, delta U equal to MCV, and this is T3 minus T2. 1 CV, where is CV? And this is given 0.7118, and this is 1501 minus 0.718. This is equal to 736.57 kilojoule. Delta U equal to, now because to solve the remaining problems I require space. Now third process is the constant volume process. For constant volume process, delta Q equal to delta this is expansion process. Delta U equal to MCV into delta T. M equal to 1, 0.7118, T3 and this is T1 minus T3, because last process minus, and this is 1 into 0. T1 equal to 300, T3 1.01. Right. Multiplied by this is equal to minus 862.31 kilojoule, and according to heat transmission, according to, so I can use first law. And this is constant volume is 0, so that's why this is minus 862.31 plus delta U. So that's why delta U equal to 31 kilojoule. Right. This is correct. Now yes, heat transfer, summations of the heat transfers Q1 2 plus plus Q23 plus Q31. Q12 equal to 0 plus Q23 equal to and this is Q23 1025.69 plus and so actually this is delta Q and this is that's why this is equal to 163.37 kilojoule and this much is the amount of the heat transfer and the summation sum of the internal energy equal to U12 plus U23 plus U31. This is 125.046 plus 1025.69 minus 862.31 and this should be equal to 0. So we'll check this 125.406 plus 1025.69 minus 862.31 constant. Because this is to be considered, I consider this, so that's why I got wrong answers. So yes, actually this is 736.57. So this is approximately 0 because this is complete cycle. So that's why this change in internal energy equal to we requires 0. But this is I got minus 0 point means 694. So that's why because of the, this is the decimal difference. But this is equal to 0. So I think these problems are sufficient. So that's why today I stop here and we'll continue some of the theory bits and remaining portions. So that's why next class, maybe last class, this is on this chapters, that is ideal gases and process with the ideal gas. So that's why today I stop here and we'll continue remaining portions of this unit in the next class and we'll complete this chapter. Thank you.